A statement issued by the Ministry of Defense deputy spokesperson Kanodel Akik confirms that four ADF terrorists under the command of Ahmed Mahmoud Hassan, commonly known as Abu Akas, have already entered the country and are intending to unleash terror on Ugandans. Akik went ahead and named the other terrorists who are believed to have sneaked into the country 2 days ago.
This is the man, Tanzanian-born bomb expert. He's called Ahmed Mahmoud Hassan, but he is called Wakas, Abu Wakas. He's currently almost the overall operations commander who does most of the planning and implementation of operations. Others in this group include Muhammad Issa, Amigo Kibirige, sometimes called Simba, Muhammad Lumisa, and Nas Hamidu Diru. And one of them is suspected to have been sent by Abu Wakasi for the current mission.
The same group is said to be behind numerous terror activities in the country, including the 2023 series of bomb and IED explosives in the various parts of the central business district. Ugandans have been warned to be on high alert, especially when in crowded areas, and should always report suspicious people and items. Those along the borders were urged to be extra vigilant.
There is a sort of border protection campaign to ensure that the people alongside our borders are more vigilant than ever before, to make sure that they inform the security forces about any suspicion of both humans and packages, to make sure that they keep safe. The people along the border should not leave security into the hands of the security forces only, because we benefit from intelligence of the population. It's the intelligence we use to protect them.
Institutions like schools, churches and others have also been urged to tighten security measures to ensure they're not victims of terror.
It is simply suicidal for these terrorists to continue making terrorism adventures in Uganda, because they will never go back. Having been hit hard in areas of Kamanda inside DRC, ADF has gone on rampage in DRC, killing civilians far away from where our forces are jointly operating with FRDC. We are sharing all plans with our counterparts, including some of the proposals the two heads of state, Uganda and DRC, made some time back on employment of LODUs or local vigilantes to stop these killings.
In the recent past, Uganda has been a victim of terror attacks, with the most recent ones being the attack on Mpondwe Lubiriha Secondary School, which saw over 37 students killed, followed by another attack in Queen Elizabeth National Park, which happened in October 2023. And this left two foreign tourists and a Uganda tour guide dead. Relatedly, the UPDF Land Forces Commander, Lieutenant General Kayanja Muhanga, has stated that as of now, there are no plans for the UPDF to withdraw from the Democratic Republic of Congo. In November 2021, the Uganda People's Defense Forces, with the blessing of Kinshasa, launched a joint operation against the ADF. The armed group stood accused of carrying out suicide bombings that claimed three lives and left scores injured in Uganda.
The terrorist is always a terrorist. Some small groups will always come into our area to disturb the population here and there. So we are not yet fully done. We and the Congo Army, we are doing a very, very good job.
The Land Forces Commander made the comments during the launch of Wazalendo Sako branch in Fort Portal. General Muhanga challenged the UPDF officers on saving
the ability to fight fear so that you don't fight fear. You know, the ability to fight fear, if you are to succeed, that's very, 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 very important. But everywhere, even in operations.
When we established this Sako, we put up a vision, we put up a mission, we have our mandate, and whatever we do on a daily basis, we must follow those.
Report compiled by Derek Asaba and Jonan Tusingwire for the news.